My lords, ladies and gentlemen, a very warm welcome back after a bit of an extended break to Transport Fever 2. So recently, the channel has had a few videos of Railway Empire 2 being focused on. The reason for this is for the past couple of weeks I have been on family vacation. And prior to the vacation, I obviously wanted to get a few videos recorded, edited and uploaded and then scheduled to release during the time that I was away, just to keep things ticking over. And when it came to recording the videos for the vacation break, I was very much engrossed in Railway Empire 2 because I'd just started one of the new chapters on that game. So that was where my attention, my focus was being drawn to. However, I'm back now, I'm pleased to say, lovely time. And we're ready to continue as per usual. So I thought it would only be right if we return to Transport Fever 2 after what has been a couple of weeks break from it. So here we are. So today this is the port of Peoria. If you remember in the last episode we got some passenger services up and running on the map between, where was it now? Let's see if we can remember. Gainesville, Peoria, and was it Sioux Falls, I believe? Either way, they're doing pretty okay. I don't think they're making us any money, but we are getting a few passengers wanting to use the service, which is a good thing. And today it's going to be about seeing if we can get more passengers using these services, especially here in Peoria. And by happy coincidence, we may also be able to get some more shipping lines set up as we're looking to achieve that as well. So let's bring up the UI and we'll discuss the strategy for this. We'll start the calendar progression. We're in 1960, the back end of 1960. So yes, this is Peoria Port. As we can see, we've got a couple of people using the ferry. Now Peoria needs both food and bricks to stimulate initial growth. So if we could supply both food and bricks, we should see some growth in Peoria. That'll give us more residents, and by extension, the logic follows, that will have more people wanting to use the ferry services. So, bricks, we've discussed this previously, we have a quarry and a brickworks down here by Murrieta, so we could supply bricks into Peoria relatively easily. And for the food, I think we'll use this food plant here over by Sioux Falls across the river. And I think my plan is to look to connect another farm into Sioux Falls. We have two nearby. And then from the food plant itself, have another line or another platform that comes back down to here, drops off back at the farm station that we have. And this farm station will be linked to a cargo port, and then the food will be shipped on the boat down into Peoria and then delivered into Peoria. So that's where we're going to see our extra shipping being brought into play as we run from here to here, well, from here to here via here, bringing food into this city. But to start with, we'll focus on the bricks because that's completely untouched, so it'll be a completely new venture for us. And nice and simply, we'll do this with some road vehicles, I think, especially getting the stone from here to here. It's a very short journey after all. So the first thing we'll do is just upgrade these roads in and around this area like that, just to make them look neat and modern and tidy. That'll do. And then we'll build another road that just cuts out all of this journey through Murrieta, so a bypass, if you will, between the quarry and our brickworks itself. So they'll just come down here, and then they'll drop off. So let's build a truck station at each end of the line. So we'll put the first one, let's make it a little bit longer. We'll put our first one just there to service a quarry, we'll put our second one just there, and that will service the brickworks. Quickly rename these, so this will be Murrieta Quarry. Nope, that's not how you spell quarry, that's quarry. Not sure what that is. There we go. And over here, this will be Murrieta Brickworks. Now we can set up this line. In fact, before we do that, let's get ourselves a road depot somewhere out here. Maybe we'll connect it in just there. So let's get a line then from Murrieta Quarry. Whoops. New line. There we go. From the quarry to the brickworks. We'll colour this one. That's roughly stone coloured. And at the quarry, we want them to take a full load and wait as long as they need to. We don't need to mess about with this because there's nothing else that you can pick up or drop off. And we'll rename this to Stone Murrieta. There we go. Now we can get some cargo vehicles to run this line. And let's see, which ones are we currently using? I think it's going to be, looks like it's going to be the Studebakers, and we'll use the Studebaker dump trucks. They're taking stone. And let's start with 15 of those. Colour them to match the line, assign them to the line, and we should start seeing stone being dropped off at our station right here. There it is. We have our first unit of stone awaiting collection. So that will slowly fill up. They can then take it over to the brickworks where it can be converted into bricks. Now getting them from the brickworks to Peoria, I think we'll likely go for another trucking route. And what we'd have them do is obviously use this station, come out here, and then part way down here we'll put another link road bypass like that, so they can head up this way, follow this road through. Let's upgrade this road as well, like so, and then they can run all the way through here, and then we can find a drop-off point in Peoria where it's gonna serve as many of the industries as we need. So I think we don't really want to put them there because we have our buses coming down here. We don't want to slow our buses down. So let's just have a look, which way do our buses run? Okay. So I think what we'll do is we'll build a new street through the town like this. We're going to have to remove some buildings, of course, to achieve this, but that's okay. So we'll build a new system like that. Our buses aren't coming down this way. Ah, they've built another road there, so we may as well take advantage, upgrade it to a slightly higher capacity road, and finish it off for them. And then let's get a truck stop down there. That way they can come through down here, and then they can come back up this way and head on through on their way back. And I think that should work okay with little, if any, interaction with our bus service. So let's test this out. We might have to use some waypoints in and around Peoria. Let's see. Nope, going exactly the way I envisioned that they would. So let's colour that red because they are carrying bricks. We won't set a wait until full order at Murrieta. They can just take whatever's available at the time when they get there. And we'll call this bricks. And this is running from Murrieta to Peoria. There we go. Now for this we're not going to need so many. In fact, looks like we're already not keeping up over here, or we've overcrowded the line, I should say. but I think once these bricks start heading into Peoria, the output here will increase, so we'll not touch the amount of vehicles there for the time being, but we might want to keep an eye on that because we might have put too many on. Anyway, for now let's focus on getting those bricks over in Peoria. And we're going to use this bad boy here with the side stakes, and we'll go for 5 to start with as an initial amount. We can always come back and adjust later to suit. So they should now be on their way. The bricks have started to be produced at the brickworks. That should kick up eventually the production over here, or the shipment over here, because at the moment they're only needing 100 out of a possible 400, so in theory this is running at 25% capacity. But when this starts to increase, this will also start to increase. And what we can do to just chivvy it along a little is also run some bricks into Murrieta at the same time. Now what we're going to do for this then is expand this station both in length and in overall width size like this. There we go. And then we're going to head up to, what is it, Murrieta? Yeah, that's right. We'll head up to Murrieta. Put a drop-off point in Murrieta for the bricks, just there. And then get ourselves a second line from here. Yep, and it's using the new terminal. And we want it to run up to here. We could loop that around, but for now it's fine. You want to be red as well, but let's give you a slightly different shade of red just so you distinguish yourself nicely from the line to Peoria. And then we'll rename this, and this is bricks, and this is only running in the Murrieta vicinity, so that's what we'll call it. There we go. And how many do we want? Perhaps not as many as 5 this time. Let's go for 3. Just to get the ball rolling and to get those bricks heading up that way. And that should also have a knock-on effect down here and see the shipment increase, especially when this industry size levels up. So that will do for a starting point. We already have some heading out there, although the second one doesn't have anything on board. And that's a consequence of us not setting a wait until full load order. But what we didn't want to do is choke up this area here with a big stream of vehicles waiting for load that won't be forthcoming, which would prevent the stone delivery trucks making their way in, which would give the stone that is needed for these vehicles that are waiting, if you follow me. So that'll do for now. So we should see Peoria, once the bricks start to arrive, grow at least just a little. So now what we want to do is look at bringing this food from over here to down here. Now to do that, like I said, I think we'll bring in a second farm, and we'll use this farm here because it's the most direct. So let's put ourselves another freight station over here. And yeah, we may as well use a terminus station this time. We don't often use those. So let's go ahead and use a terminus station. In fact, no, it's not, because otherwise it's going to jut out too far down here. No, we'll use a regular style station. And let's just get that so it has an active connection, if we can. What about over the top there? Okay, well, I think might have to delete this road, which is fine. It isn't doing us anything anyway. So we'll delete this entire road here from the town over to the farm. Just like so. Now we can put our station in here, hopefully. Just get it lined up nicely. think it's colliding with the tree boundaries, which is causing the issue. Right, let's have it there then. That'll do. And then you're just gonna have to do a sharp bend as it comes down this way and then into Sioux Falls East, which we shall rename actually to the Sioux Falls Food Plant. That's better. Right, so what do we have going off here at the moment? So we have one in and one out. So I think what we will do, we have some new vehicles available, not too many this time around. So the lines coming in, we have the grain coming in, which is coming in from down here. And then we have the food going out to Norfolk, which is from this platform here. So to save things getting in each other's way, I think what we'll do is give this an extra platform down here, extend this platform that way a little bit, just so we've got a bit more length to work with. And then from here, let's get the track building tool, not to do that, but do that instead. That's a bit more reasonable, isn't it? So I have another platform coming through here. Now we need, or we're going to need a way to get from a train depot to this new platform, so we'll have to figure that out. But in the meantime, we can focus on getting this running into the new station over here. Now, as I said, we're going to have a pretty sharp bend here from here to here. It's going to be tight, so we're going to have quite a bit of speed reduction, speed loss on approach to the station. But I think we can get away with that, and I don't think it's going to be too much of an issue. So let's see, if we just did a straight run, where are you? Where's our track? There it is. Ah, you see, that's, yeah, it's too much. It's too much. Well, let's just try. Yeah, what's going off there? Too much slope. That's the problem there. We've got too much slope. Oh, wow, that is quite a slope right there, isn't it? Okay, so what we'll do, let's rethink this. And that line we've just built, rather than have it allow the game to dictate the terrain height or the track height, is we'll just measure what heights we're at each end. So over here we're at 10 meters. And then up at the station over here that we've just built, we're at 8 meters. So if we have this one, in fact, over this way, let's do it from this way, this makes more sense. Let's have this track go to 8 meters, like that, 8 meters. And then from this point, let's have it maintain its height at 8 meters. And then have it come through here. It's going to be quite a long tunnel, but I think we can reduce the tunnel length somewhat by only going as far as that. And then from here, switch into earthworks. And the cutting will look initially quite severe, but we can use the terrain terraforming tools to address that. And then bring that in. There we go. So, in fact, that slowdown's not too bad. 41 miles per hour, it's not the worst. There we go. Now, like I said, what we also need to do is find a way for these trains to have access to a depot. Now, I think initially we were using a depot. Where was it? I thought we'd put one down here somewhere. Perhaps I was mistaken. Now, it must have been this depot all the way up here. Now, if it's that depot, that's fine. Because what we can do is from this end, perhaps at this junction here, is just take a single line, have it stay level and straight like that, so the overlap looks pretty tidy, which that one really doesn't. So let's try that again. Make sure we delete the right bit of track there. So what we'll have to do instead then is we'll cross it over just to ensure a nice crossing. Now stay level. And that should be better. Again, not really. So let's rethink that then. Okay, so instead let's go parallel. I know these speeds are quite slow, but I can live with that. And then there we go, that's better. Just notice we have floating catenary there, which is a little bit awkward, but we'll keep it for now. We're not going to be looking at it too much, and we're going straight into the industry here, so we need to kick that out a little bit more aggressively, like that. And I know the gradient on these tracks is quite steep and excessive, but it's only going to be used as a link between the depot and this line over here. Now we have a bit of a bridge there. Let's swap that for earthworks instead, and we'll raise the ground up to meet the track instead. And then let's have this come parallel there before joining in like that. And what we'll also do is, because we might have, do we want just the one train running this? Yeah, I think for now we'll just have one train, so we don't even need to worry about any signals or passing loops. So let's get another grain supply line set up from there to there, using the only way it can, which is obviously fine. And over there we want them to have a full load and wait as long as you need to get that full load. And this is, oh, it's all within Sioux Falls again. So this is RC, that's rail cargo. And Sioux Falls, oh, I've gone the wrong way around. We want the grain first and then the area, which is just Sioux Falls, like that. We can get the grain train from over here because it can come this way. It will have to go into this station first and then head back. That's okay. It just gives a bit more time for the station over here to fill up with grain. So let's buy ourselves a grain train. We don't need anything too powerful, really. I think maybe the Baldwin will do. Maybe go for, yeah, go for that one, the re-engineered variant. So pop you on. How much do you cost, actually? 1 million. This might be a bit of a loss maker for us, at least initially, but that's fine. Stick some gondolas on here. 270. What rating is that? That's mediocre. Let's just take a couple off, because this is just to supplement the existing grain supply. Yeah, that will do. Like I said, we'll just have one of these. Put that on the auxiliary line, which is this one here, the one we can see on our screen, just here, hidden behind the menus. And this is just to ensure we have enough grain being brought into this industry that we can start supplying multiple cities from this industry. So the next thing we want to do is another line from here down to here, and we'll do the same thing. We'll configure this. We want the tracks here, that's it. We'll extend this out a little, like that. That train's got confused because I was amending the station while he was there. So let's just have you return or head with a partial load just to get you out of the way and stop you from complaining. Yeah, so we'll extend this like we did up at the food production plant out that way, just so we have a longer platform for our train. And we want you to come out here. Let's have you stay nice and flat. And then what we want to do is link in like that. We want to make that a double slip switch, so the train coming back can use the double slip switch to get to this platform. So then they can share this this bit of track all the way around. Let's put in a fourth platform over here. I don't think we're going to be able to go too far with this one because the track curves. Now we'll have to just have a small train here. As we can see, we don't have much space to work with. Who's unhappy now? Grain to Sioux Falls could not connect all stations. Which one is that? Is that the one we've just constructed? Yes, it is. Well, why can't you? Because you've changed your platform. Well, nobody asked you to do that. There we go. And then we'll just repeat the process up here. Have it come out, stay straight, stay nice and level. Merge across, like, not like that, it's too much slope. Okay, let's have it come a little bit further out then, and then merge them together, like that. And again, with the double slip switch over here, there we go. And again, if we just have one train, and it'll be a fairly short train at that, just because this platform length over here dictates that. Then we can start bringing food down to here, and then we can set up a cargo shipping service. So we'll do that before we set up the train, because if we set up the train, there's no demand for food down here, so the food wouldn't be produced. So let's get a cargo harbour down here, one terminal. And what we're going to need to do here then? Yeah, we can't, because this track here isn't station track, so we can't put a platform building down here. So we're going to have to link it in with a road. Now hopefully they're close enough together that they will link together without too many issues, or without having to have a trucking service doing a short run between the cargo terminal and the station, but we shall see. What do we have? Some new vehicles, the BN and the BN reverse. So let's see about this then. Ooh, the GM Blue Sky, very nice. I guess the reverse variant as well. Yep, there it is. The Great Northern, let's follow the pattern. The Great Northern reverse, yep, there it is. So do they link together? Yes, they do. Thank God for that. So we don't need any trucks involved here, which is great. And we've got it all linked together. I don't know why you hump up and hump down, but since nothing's going to be run on it, it doesn't really matter. So from there, what we can do over here is hopefully put another dock here, a cargo dock. Can we put it that way? Yes, we can. Let's put a large landing bay there. And can we put a cargo building in just to complete the look? Yes, we can. It's a bit sideways, but it doesn't really matter. So we can now get a shipping line from there to there. Again, we'll not do that yet because there's no demand for anything, so we'd be wasting our time. What we're going to need finally then is a truck station down here that picks up the incoming food. So I'll pop it there. An unload point. Well, which way do our buses go around here? All this area here is free of buses, so that's good. So let's get an unload point here, and then we can do from there to there with that colour. And this is the Peoria food delivery. Whoops, Whoops, what's going off here? Clicking all the wrong things, bear with me. There we go. So food delivery for Peoria. We'll get the vehicles running this one first of all. What we're probably going to need to do is have a few cargo buildings over here, because we may have a point in the future where the ships are dropping off so much that we're losing cargo, because it overfills the platform. So these should help in that regard. Let's work from the final end back. So we'll get the food delivery trucks first of all, and we'll just get three of those like that. So they're going to be running dry for a little while, but that's okay. Now we can do the shipping route. So from there to there, and that's that colour. Load if available or full load? We'll put load if available initially. And this is S, shall we say, shipping. Why not? And this is food. I will go Sioux Falls to Peoria here, even though it says Peoria to Peoria. So what way are you going? Okay, you're doing that, aren't you? Well, why not? We need a ship, and our shipyard is over here. Let's get the ship. And we want cargo ship. What can you take? You can take food. The Ashalp, or the Axalp, I'm not sure how you pronounce it. One is going to be more than enough for this, at least initially. Can't see the line yet, so let's just come over here. You go onto that line, and now we can get the train line set up. So from here to back here, you're using that new platform there and there, so that's good. Let's have you wait for a full load at the food plant as long as you need to. We're only going to have one train anyway, so you're not going to get in anybody's way while you are waiting. Call you the darker of the two oranges. Yep, that's all good. Rename it, and this is food Sioux Falls, like that. Get ourselves a train. We can use this depot up here actually, because they can just come all the way down. So buy vehicles, locomotives. Now, as I said, we don't need anything too big here. Could go for a little shunter like this. I know it only does 65 miles per hour, but why not? Yeah, let's go for that. Cargo, box cars it is we want. We don't need anything too big. I think maybe 150 meters at the most. Mediocre rating. That's not too bad. One of those. There we go. Colour that the orange. And then put that on that food there. So we have the auxiliary grain supply. There's a train for that. I guess you've not made the delivery yet. No, you haven't. You're not producing very much, but that's fine. It just says to me that this is able to keep up with demand for now, which is okay. If that auxiliary service doesn't make us any money, then so be it. But over time, we might see this become a bit more crucial to our efforts. So you should now start producing for this platform as well. You're shipping 10 out to Peoria at the moment. Of course, Peoria is not demanding a great amount of food initially, just 56 units. As we can see, we've had some deliveries of bricks in Peoria already at this point. So this is still backlogged. That's jumped up to 200, however, which says to me that this industry has expanded over here. And yes, indeed, it has. So that's good to see. We might need some more brick delivery trucks on these, but we can come back to that at a future episode. I think for now, we'll call it a day on this episode. And in terms of cab ride for the outro, I think we might go on our new train, if I can find it. It's all the way over there, yeah. So what we'll do is pause the calendar, and I'll let this train run to... I'll let it get to Sioux Falls, somewhere around here, and then we'll have a cab ride from wherever we get from back here, all the way through to this station. In fact, we may as well jump on it straight away. Yeah, why not? We'll jump on it straight away. So let's get on board. So that's poor, so we're not going to miss any unlocks. Hop on board, and we'll have a ride to the food plant from here. So I hope you've enjoyed returning to Transport Fever 2. I certainly have. It wasn't a deliberate or intentional effort on my part to focus on Railway Empire 2 prior to my vacation. Like I said, I just got swept up. Because you know how it is when you start something new and exciting, such as a new mission and so on and so forth. And yeah, that's why. But we are back and service, normal service, hopefully is now resumed. Might not be able to do, you know, every day during the week videos because it is the summer holidays, of course. So the children are now off school, which does mean things are quite noisy during the day, which is what I prefer to record. It's usually when they're at school, you see. I'll still try and aim for 2 to 3 videos per week, and we will do an even blend between Transport Fever 2 and Railway Empire 2. But regardless, I hope you've enjoyed today's episode and the return to Transport Fever 2. As always, comments are welcome down below, and if you have enjoyed the video, then please consider hitting the thumbs up button down below. And if you'd like to stay up to date with new video releases, then consider subscribing to the channel as well. At this point, a very special thank you to my supporters on Patreon. Your generosity is deeply appreciated, so thank you very much indeed. But for now, all that remains for me to say is, as always, ladies and gentlemen, take very good care of yourselves. It's ta-ta for now.